Everybody's singing and away we go. It's the way we go everywhere you go.
Though it's just a simple little thing,
there's something about it makes you wanna sing. From Maine to California, back to Kokomo, even roosters crow, and away we go. It's easy as pie, kiss your kid goodbye, and away we go. Something about it makes you wanna sing. From Maine to California, back to Kokomo, even roosters crow, and away we go. It's easy as pie, kiss your kids goodbye, and away.
Thank you indeed for joining us once again on the Sunnyside Express, and we hope that in the next hour we're going to take you to some interesting places and show you some very wonderful things. Right now, if you listen closely, you may hear bells ringing. To tell you the why and the wherefore, here are the Thin Men.
Sister Sue in a bonnet pretty blue.
Here comes Brother John running down, down the avenue.
They know what the bells are saying, and they've come to do their praying on this fine Sunday morning.
Hear them bells,
hear them bells, hear them bells,
hear them bells,
hear them bells, hear them bells. High up in the belfry swinging, happy song they're singing on this fine Sunday morning.
From the far off hills they keep coming, one and all,
Bible in their hands in answer to their call.
They know what the bells are saying, and they've come to do their praying on this fine Sunday morning.
Hear them bells,
hear them bells, hear them bells,
hear them bells,
hear them bells, hear them bells. The belfry swinging, what a happy song they're singing on this fine Sunday morning, on this fine Sunday morning. Hear them bells, hear them bells, on this fine Sunday morning.
Good heavens, I wish that Sydney would hurry up. I'm supposed to meet him here. Hello, Honest. How are you, sir?
Listen, have you seen Sydney?
Well, I haven't seen him, but I'm supposed to meet him here. He should be. Here he comes now.
Oh, there he is. What are you doing here?
Down
anyway?
A bit.
Oh, we're waiting here. See, this is the magic blue room here.
The magic what room?
The magic blue room. We're going in. There's a secret bell in there that rings. Tell him about it.
That's right. If you take a girl into that room, if the bell you put hold a hand and the bell rings once.
Hold a hand and the bell rings once?
That's right.
Put your arm around her waist and the bell rings twice.
And if you kiss her, the bell rings three times.
Mysterious bell.
And nobody's been ever to find the bell.
I don't even believe this.
You don't?
Oh,
it's a dead set mag, for sure.
As soon as a girl comes along, I'll show you what happens.
Show him, Molly.
Oh, pardon me, charmer.
Do you mind if I take a rent?
Will you take your turn here?
Just take a rest. Would you like to see the magic blue room?
I'd love to.
Oh, come on.
Will you come out of here?
Wait there. Come on, dear. I'll show you.
Do you mind if I come with
you? Will you come back here?
Be your block, son.
Just take your turn, that's all. He's going to show you what happened.
Now, Fee.
Come here. He's holding a hand. He's got his arm around her waist.
He's kissing her.
You see?
Naughty boy.
What about that?
Boy, here he comes. There you are. Would you like to come again?
Anytime.
Oh. Here, let's get away, will you? Look, I'll tell you what, the next girl that comes along, me in. Right?
No, excuse
I'm sorry,
me.
The next girl, Murray,
me.
I don't.
Here we go. Here, get out of it, will you?
Stand easy, will you?
Wait your turn. Excuse me, dear. Would you like to come into the blue room with me?
That sounds rather wonderful.
Well, come along, then.
Thank you.
Can I come?
Get out of it!
Hold everything.
No, I get it, Dad.
Listen. Holding her hand.
The charm around.
Round away.
Kissing you?
No, not me, will you?
Oh. Well, it was very nice.
Can I get
you
a
chance? Enjoy that?
Wait. It was just wonderful.
Well, I'll see you later.
Wonderful. Do I get a go or don't I?
Well, look, son, listen. I'll tell you what we'll do. The next one is yours.
The next girl is yours.
Right, are you?
The next one's yours, for sure. Now.
Look,
be a man.
Now I've changed my... Oh.
Go on.
I've changed my mind.
Be a man, will you?
No, but she doesn't look too honest.
It's
sort,
your
does
turn.
No, I've changed my mind. I've
you
lost,
said the next
on
one's yours.
I've lost the urge and all. I don't know if you know it or not, but you got spuds in your socks. Nice Beecham's pill, this. Got head like a twisted sand chip. No. Look, I don't think I'll take
go
it.
On.
Come on. Well, look, you wouldn't want to go into the blue room, would you?
Oh, yeah.
Will you? Cut it out. Now, I'm sure you wouldn't want to go into the blue room, would you? But, look, I don't want to fancy going in at all myself.
Oh, yeah.
Go on, get in.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Be a man.
Shut up.
He's holding a hand. He's got his arm around her waist. He's kissing her.
What happened? Hey, what happened?
I found the flaming bell.
Oh, yeah.
In our program tonight, we're very happy to introduce a very lovely young guest star. She's going to sing with backing by the Cordairs. It's a very lovely young person. I'm sure you'll enjoy her performance. Janice Taylor. She sings for us Romance from the Desert Song.
You. Got everything, you know. What time is it?
Oh, dear. Do you really have to go to work tonight, dear?
Well, you know, when I took this job to fix the TV sets, I'd have to be out any time they want their TV sets fixed.
Yes, dear, I know, but I'll be so lonely.
Oh, look, you'll be lonely. I'll only be about an hour. Now, don't worry about it now. I've got
right
everything
then.
Now, ta-da.
All right, John. Bye-bye. Ah.
Is he gone yet?
Yes, he's gone.
Well, I don't know how you put up with that fellow. He's out working all day, comes home and has his tea, and as soon as he's had tea, he races out repairing TV sets again.
Yes, I know, Bill. It is a nerve-wracking life, but after all, he is my husband, and I'll have to put up with it.
Bell, I know that you don't love him, and you don't have to put up with it. Now, listen.
Oh, I know that, Bill. Let's not go...
Listen, footsteps. Who is it?
Oh, I don't know. Quickly, behind the screen.
Listen, you know that main screwdriver of mine?
Oh, a screwdriver? Oh,
well, I've got to have that.
Oh, have you, dear?
Oh, there it is.
Oh,
there.
I'll get it for you, dear.
Oh,
yes.
Hurry up,
yes.
Then that's the main thing.
The main thing.
Oh, that's
the
little beauty. That fixes everything,
yes.
That. Well, I'm off now.
You're right, John.
Yes, yes.
Goodbye, John.
Goodbye, pal. Ta-da, Bill.
Looking through ancient mythology, we find many strange tales of sailors being lured from their ships by sirens and never being heard of again. As the stories spread, sailors began to tie themselves to the masts of their ships to avoid this unknown fate. On these stories, we base tonight's ballet with original choreography by Betty Meddings and featuring Patricia Cox and Teddy Miller.
Sunnyside Express is pulling into Magic Land. The sorcerer's apprentice, Shirlene Clancy, has finally become a fully-fledged magician by learning those magic words, flim, flam, flu.
You're gonna be a daddy. I'm with you and I've had 14 children.
14?
Yeah.
You must be a producer.
Never mind about that. Now, look.
Listen, you're sure it'll be all right?
It'll be all right. Just sit
You've
down.
Had 14?
14, yes. Sit there.
Hey, what are all these jokers
doing? They're all here for the same reason as you are.
They're all gonna be daddies?
All going to be daddies, yes.
This tough joker up here?
Of course he is.
This joker here?
That's right, yes.
What about him?
He's here for the same reason as you are.
You're kidding, aren't you?
The same reason as you are. Sit down.
Well, what about some of the kids you want to know?
Mr. Basher?
Yes, that's me.
Well, you are the father
yeah?
of a 10-pound bouncing baby boy. Congratulations.
A 10-pound baby boy. You hear that, cook? A 10-pound baby boy.
10-pound, that's nothing. I found a 20-pound flounder the other day.
20-pound flounder? You calling my kid a fish?
That's just a little chip.
Come here,
I'll give it a 10-pound
baby boy.
Will I go on like that?
Because you will.
Well, you want to know.
Mr. Garibaldi.
Si, si, signora.
Ah. Well, now. You are the father of twins, mother and babies, all well, congratulations.
Twins? Oh, what do you think of Tony now? Twins.
Twins.
Salamio.
Oh, shove it up, you jumper. Twins, eh? Must be the spaghetti. What about the Aljack?
He's here for the same reason as you are.
Sure he is?
Of course, sit down here.
How old are you, Dad?
Eh?
How old are you?
99.
99, one more year and his lease runs out. How long have you been married?
10 years.
10 years and 99, that's not a bad average. Better than Richie Benner. What are you laughing for? You ought to be. Give him a light.
Well, a light is...
Yeah, give him a light. He wants a light.
If you don't mind,
young fella. He sure is here for the same reason
as... He's here for the same reason as you are. Give him a light. That's it. Puff, puff.
You got a light there?
No.
Yes,
no.
Yeah, I've only got one match. I'll just
light this thing for you. What are you doing with that?
I'd like this light to see.
Got any matches? You got any matches?
Yeah.
Got everything here.
The gunpowder's not working.
Oh!
Finally gets onto this.
Here!
Oh, hang on, I'll put it out.
Look, put it down here!
Now look, he's here for the same reason as you are.
Sit down. He's here for the same reason as you.
Are you here for the... Well, you want to know.
Yes. Mr. Senile?
Yes, that's me.
Oh, well now, you are the father of triplets. Congratulations!
Triplets! How do you like a triplet?
Yes, that is right. Triplets! Did you hear that, young fella?
I heard it, all right. I got it. Did you get them?
I got it, all right. And I'll be back again.
I don't think he'll make it back for you. I think it's his last trip.
That's his last trip.
Sit down, will you?
You know,
no. You know, there's something very funny about this. The fella on the end, he had one.
Yes.
The bloke beside him had two.
That's right.
And the old joker had three.
That's right.
And I'm four.
Oh, listen, I've all... Don't worry, I've helped you with everything, haven't I?
Yeah, but not with this.
No. Well, look, don't worry. Don't you
worry. All right, I won't worry, because you ought to know.
That's right.
Mr. Hyland!
Yes, Mert? What is it?
It's a rabbit!
Haunting me.
nestles in my arms so tenderly. There's a thrill that words cannot express. In my heart a song of love is taunting me. Melody haunting me.
Moral to this next number to be presented by Vel Ruff and Bill French. No matter what your occupation, if you have talent, you'll go a long way. But if you have this certain something that we're going to tell you about, you'll probably go a lot further and may even rise right to the top. It's known by many names, but tonight, to be polite, we'll call it flattery.
Like no girl I know. I gotta confess that I'm lucky to be your beau.
Oh, you and your fancy flattery, the sugary things you say.
You're nice to
you
hold.
You figure that if you flatter me, that you're gonna get your way.
Good looking too.
So the minute you ring my bell.
And I do.
Well, why do I get so fluttery? I know it's a crafty plan.
You're sweet to
a
kiss.
Difficult trick to flatter me and take me for all you
it's
can.
It's love, it's love, it's love.
But somehow I just don't care.
Yeah?
So flutter away while I pull up a chair.
Now look at those legs there.
Cause flattery will get you nowhere. You fill out that suit.
Huh? What's that?
Like no guy.
Who, me?
Nah.
Your torso's a beast.
Go on.
It's no wonder those gals fall down.
Oh, you and your fancy flattery, you're laying it on for spite. You figure you'll charge my battery, and I'll get too hot to fight. It's time you were took in tow.
Yeah, I know.
That flattery stuff don't go.
No.
Oh, no. Why do I get these crazy chills? I ought to be roped and tied.
You
kiss sure
so
as a green in dollar bills, you're taking me for
you're
a ride.
Wrong. It's
not. But somehow I just don't care. So flatter away while I pull up a chair.
Hey, look at those muscles.
Cause flattery will get you nowhere. Hey, you know, we ought to do an act together.
Yeah, we'd make a great team. Like Bert and Graham, maybe?
Vel, there's only one thing wrong. You're a girl.
Heck!
We decided we don't care.
Flatter away while I pull up a chair.
Make us a cute pair.
Cause flattery
we'll get you nowhere.
Thank you very much indeed, Vel Ruff and Bill French, but I think they've got the moral wrong. It should be that flattery will get you anywhere. Most young people during their impressionable years like to model themselves upon some great artist who has been a success in their chosen field. I think with our very popular young tenor, Ron Lees, it was Mario Lanza. And I feel sure that you'll recognize some of the Lanza-like qualities in this particular number as Ron Lees sings, Because You're Mine.
Because you're mine, the brightest
little star I see looks down my love and envies me. Because you're mine, because you're mine, because you're mine. The breeze that hurries by becomes a melody.
Why?
Because you're mine, because you're mine. I only know, as long as I may live, I only live for that kiss that you alone may give me. And when we kiss, that isn't thunder, dear, it's only my poor heart to hear. And it's applause, because you're mine. Because you're mine, dear. The love you give me. And when we kiss, that isn't thunder, dear, it's only my poor heart to hear, and it's applause.
Never
mind about
front.
It. Just get on with the gardening. Get on with it, Sid.
All right, don't start nagging
again. Nag? I'll nag you. That's what I'll do to you, nag you. Do a bit of gardening. It'll do you a lot more good than loafing in the pub all day.
Well, after Anzac Day, you're kidding, aren't you, man? She'll be down there recuperating.
Will you get on with it? Get on with it.
All right. Get out before I stab you in four places.
Stop.
Keep that baby quiet. It's always falling. I think I'll give the lawn a bit of a spray. Hi, Mo. Hi, Mo. Turn the tap on, will you?
It's turned on.
It's not turned on. There's no water coming out of it. Hey. There's
water coming out of it,
is it? Hey. What did you
take?
Oh, what?
That was in the last kit.
Come here, will you? None of the props are working tonight.
What are you doing? A bit of gardening, are you?
No, I'm having a game of tennis.
Well, you should be like me playing golf.
Now it's starting to work.
Eh? Oh, you're growing some vegetables.
Yeah, how did you get?
Oh, look.
Garlic. What's a garlic for? I feed it to the baby so we can find him in the dark. Listen, you want to be careful growing vegetables.
What?
Well, I'll tell you what. I planted some rhubarb and up came celery.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Well, you know what I planted once?
What?
A tomcat.
Yeah?
And up came the health inspector.
Now, look, will you take
What are you going to do now, then?
Nosey, will you take off?
What are you going to do?
I'm going to mow the lawn.
Well, I'll walk up and down with you. We'll talk about the footy. Come on.
No, don't bother. I know what you're
doing. Oh, just have a little walk up and down
I'm
with
having
you.
Enough trouble with the missus without...
Come on. Trouble. Here we go. Back. Back.
Are you going to keep this up all
day? I've
got
to walk with you.
When you get out of the place, or I'll give you the money.
What will you do?
Get out. I'll give you the... Oh, what are you doing all
well,
over
there? Well. Gardening, I see. That's what I like.
You like a little bit of gardening, eh?
Every man should have a hobby, and what finer hobby than growing vegetables?
He's got something there, you know.
So he has, too.
But are you getting what you deserve?
Oh, you'll get what you deserve if you don't hurry up and get out and take this flare with you.
Are you getting the best from your carrots?
Well, I'll have a look. They look all right to me.
Are your cauliflowers blooming as they should? And what about your rhubarb?
Rhubarb? Look,
don't answer him. He wants you to say something, then he'll say, suck it and see.
I mean, have you cultivated your rhubarb so that it contains the right amount of food calories? Does it contain the amount of iron necessary for food vitamins?
I don't know. How would I know? Well, listen to him. Well, it sounds like a rat waiting to live.
What's going on here?
Ah, the little wife, I take it. Yeah, the little wife, and you can take her any time you like.
Listen!
That'll be it. Oops, enough of that.
Will you stop hobnobbing with your pals and get on with the gardening? I'm trying to get the baby to sleep.
All right. Will you shut it up? Right. Now, go on, tell us.
Now, having studied in our lab.
In your where?
Laboratory.
In the laboratory.
Well, having studied in our laboratories, we have perfected what we call our 5-minute fertilizer. Right. Now, in this box...
He's going to do a trick. Give me my hand. I do tricks myself. Look. Oh.
Can you do that again?
Yeah, why not? I'll bet you can't. Hey, we nearly lost it. Hang on to it, will you?
Now, in this box, I have the essence of the 5-minute fertilizer. Place one of these at the root of any plant, and bingo! The puny parsnip becomes as big as a giant oak. The little potato becomes as large as a pumpkin. And your cherry becomes as big as a football.
Oh, really?
Now, I'll place these down here.
I'm not interested, if you don't mind.
You'll be interested now. Look, sir, here we have the pinnacle of our investigation.
Listen,
you're not still talking, are you?
I can't get an edge in word way.
Now, look, sir, let me explain this to you. All you've got to do is place one of these at the point of it. Now, when are you? All you've got to do is if you don't and I can guarantee, sir, if you're not satisfied, I'll return your money with the same civility as which I took it.
I'm not interested. You can both nick right off and let me get on with the gun.
All right, I'll go. Just a moment.
What's the matter?
Somebody's taken a dollar's worth of my fertilizer.
Your wife gave one of those lollies to the baby. My wife gave the baby 5-minute fertilizer?
Yes.
Oh, no. Val! Where's the baby?
In the town there lived a maid, might well what I do say. It's in the town there lived a maid, and she was mistress of her trade. I'll go no more, I'll go with you. Roman's been my rule, I am a gold or a Roman with you, fair maid. I took this fair maid for a walk, not well what I do say. Ooh, I took this fair maid for a walk, and we had such a lovely talk. A gold or a Roman with you, fair maid. A Roman, a Roman, since Roman's been my rule, I am a gold or a Roman with you, fair maid.
Oh,
But we'll go down to Mother Rackets and we'll pawn our monkey jackets and we'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. We'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. We'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. We'll go down to Mother Rackets and we'll pawn our monkey jackets and we'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. Hey! Hey! And we'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. Her decks are rotten and the planks are weak and the old house shakes and the seams all leak. A sailor's life when he's out at sea is full of trouble and misery. We'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. We'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. We'll go down to Mother Rackets and we'll pawn our monkey jackets and we'll have another drink before the boat shoves up. A robin, a robin, since Robin's been my ruin, I'll go no more a robin with you, fair men. A robin, since Robin's been my ruin, I'll go no more a robin with you, fair men.
Let your love become blue.